Ladies and gentlemen, accompanied by his head of security, is the NWA Georgia Heavyweight Champion, Tommy Too Much!
What in the heck is this? Tommy Too Much is coming out to the ring with his security guard and Al Getz.
Al Getz, who has a match up here tonight.
Absolutely. I'm not really sure what the heck's going on here. We'll have to see what's going on. Al Getz wearing a Macho Man shirt as well. Big Chad, I'm not really sure what's going on. I'll have to see what Tommy Too Much has to say here as we go to Tommy Too Much.
May I please have your attention? I will say this again. May I please have your attention? I am your new Georgia champion, and you will treat me as such. Every one of you people who had the money to be here last week seen me defeat Odinson for this championship. It is mine. Now, last night in Barnesville, Georgia, Rick Michaels had the audacity to make me, so he thinks, defend this championship today against some TNA star by the name of Gunner. Now, I have acquired this gentleman's services. Last night, shut up, old woman! Last night, I assisted this gentleman and Tyson Dean and Andy Anderson becoming the new NWA Tag Team Champions. In return, I have agreed to train him how to be a professional wrestler. Why? Because I am the NWA Georgia champion, which means I am the best that this company has to offer. Now, this man has informed me that what Rick Michaels has stated that I have to do is something I don't have to do. Unconstitutional. There is no contract, neither written nor verbal. So TNA Gunner can take his nasty trunks, his big massive thighs, and he can get on that plane and he can carry his stinking butt back ever to where it is he thinks he calls a home, because that match is not going to happen. So I bid all of you dirty Obama-loving rednecks farewell. I will see you at the big show. Tommy, too much? You're exactly right.
NWA Atlanta Commissioner Rick Michaels.
You're exactly right. I did make this match. And you will defend that title against Gunner. And you know what, Tommy? You will defend that title right now. Get me a referee out here.
All right. General Manager Rick Michaels has ordered that Tommy Too Much take on TNA's Gunner here in a NWA Georgia title match. Tommy Too Much isn't even in gear, Big Chad.
I know what. Obviously, he didn't expect to wrestle tonight.
Yeah, no kidding.
He told the crowd.
Yes, he was heading to Huddle House.
but obviously, Gunner's ready to go.
Yeah, Gunner's got his gear on. He's got his boots. He's ready to take on Tommy Too Much. And I tell you what, Chad, this is another thing here that tells you exactly what NWA Atlanta is all about. You got a gentleman the size of a big star like Gunner coming in here to take on Tommy Too Much and the NWA Georgia Heavyweight Championship. Senior referee Tristan Michaels, no relation, is in charge of this matchup here. He has started a count now as Tommy Too Much is on the entrance ramp. Al Getz has attained his services in training, so I have to see if Al Getz has any effect to the outcome of this match, if Getz is going to remain out here.
Absolutely.
Referee Tristan Michaels has asked for the bell. The bell has rung, and he is instituting a 10 count trying to get Tommy into the ring, which honestly isn't a bad idea. If Tommy gets a count out, he loses the match, but he doesn't lose the title.
Which sounds like a perfect Tommy Too Much ending.
Absolutely.
If you will.
But as we saw here 2 weeks ago right here in Locust Grove, Tommy Too Much became victorious over Odinson in taking that title. Honestly, he had the NWA Atlanta Heavyweight Championship and now is the NWA Georgia Champion as well. But one of those belts probably belongs to a security guard.
He usually does a lot of work in the match.
Yes.
I hope he gets paid very well.
I hope so, but he does save some money on shampoo.
He does. That's.
Oh, we'll see. Too Much has got a little bit of a yellow streak here right now as it goes to Gunner. Gunner's looks like he's stretched out and ready to go. Too Much came in looking for a night off. But as we have seen, when he puts his mind to it and he's ready to focus on a match, there's not too many guys that are as dangerous as Tommy Too Much in the ring. You have to keep an eye on him. He's out of the ring now. Doesn't want any part of Gunner right now, that is for sure. We've got a loaded night of action here tonight. I think it's going to culminate in the main event this evening as DeWitt Dawson takes on one Al Getz in his Macho Man t-shirt. I have
yes.
to see which one of them is a Macho Man. And a loser leaves NWA Atlanta match. That's going to be our main event here this evening. Yeah. We're looking forward to seeing that.
And if you remember back in the early 90s, the loser leaves match between the Macho Man and the Undertaker.
Yes,
who
true.
Lost that match. So yep. Maybe he should get a Ultimate Warrior t-shirt instead.
That's
I don't know.
Possible. Maybe, sure. I'm not sure they have
just
Ultimate
saying.
Warrior shirts at TJ Maxx or wherever it is that Al Getz shops. Al Getz is known to stretch a dollar, just to say. Whoa!
Oh.
Tommy Too Much has pushed referee Tristan Michaels here at ringside. Tommy's jawing with the fans here now at ringside. Not really sure what's going on. Tristan Michaels has got another 10 count here.
Actually, he threatened the gentleman's wife a while ago.
Gunner has offered to go outside the ring and get Tommy Too Much in the ring. Tristan Michaels tapped Too Much on the shoulder here, and we saw what happened to him. Let's see if, Tommy Too Much reached back, and he realizes that ain't Tristan Michaels.
Oh, Lord.
That is Gunner standing right in front of him. Big right hand from Gunner on the outside of the ring. It's Too Much is stunned. Too Much is around the corner there. Security now is backing away. Gunner is taking Too Much's head right off the ring apron. He's going to get him loaded up and sent right back into the ring. He's outside. Head first right into the barricade. Gunner said there's going to be no more running. Slides Tommy Too Much into the ring, and Too Much is in the corner, backing off, asking for a timeout. As 30 plus years of watching wrestling tells me, there's no timeouts. I don't know what he's doing. Guess that's something they don't go over in wrestling school.
You don't look at a day over 29.
Thank you, Chad. head first right in the top turnbuckle. Tommy Too Much. Uh-oh. Gunner. Oh, my God. Gunner just ripping the shirt right off of Too Much. Big chop right in the chest. Too Much. Another chop sends Tommy Too Much right down to the ring, to the canvas.
That's one of the designer shirts, too.
That's an expensive one of a kind there. It's really not fair, honestly. Tommy Too Much wasn't expecting to wrestle tonight. He's getting his shirts torn up.
Well, the one thing about Rick Michaels is if he says you're going to do something, by God, you're going to do it.
Going for number 10 right off the top of the head of Tommy Too Much, and Too Much is stunned, stumbling out of the corner there. Big right hand right at the top of the head. Let's see if Gunner hooks the far leg. Two count there from Tristan Michaels. Man, what a coup this would be. Gunner coming in here and taking the NWA Georgia Championship.
Oh!
Al gets into the ring now with a low blow on Gunner. As Tommy Too Much grabs Tristan Michaels. Al gets paying for one training lesson here with a shot to the groin, of Gunner. And Tommy Too Much, the tide has turned in Too Much's
right
favor.
Hand. Wow.
Tristan Michaels has his back turned now as a referee. Look at that. Too Much is bouncing around in the corner there to distract the referee and not knowing that his security guard's in the corner beating up Gunner. I tell you what, these two guys have this interference down to a science now.
Absolutely.
Security guard has sent a water bottle. Too Much now asking for a water break as security punches Gunner right in his head here. Tristan Michaels now distracted once again. Security is back in the ring now just punching Gunner right in the top of the head. Tristan Michaels trying to figure out what on earth Tommy Too Much is doing with that bottle of water. We've seen the interference coming by way of what the Beautiful Ball Besties have done with the water and the different things they've spit in Fried Eddie's face.
Absolutely.
So we've had a mandate there to keep an eye on that kind of stuff. Too Much settling into a chin lock there. Gunner trying his best to get out of that hold. Trying to grab a hold of one of the hands, some fingers there, so he can get Tommy Too Much's hands around from his neck and loosen that hold so he can get to a vertical base here. NWA Atlanta fans chanting, let's go, Gunner. Tommy Too Much sent Gunner right out on the floor. Ring announcer Jason Boyd here scrambling at ringside as Tommy Too Much once again distracting Tristan Michaels in security here at ringside working over Gunner. I tell you what, Rick Michaels has got to take a look at this video and see what's going on here at ringside with Tommy Too Much and his security. We got a backbreaker there. Too Much hits on Gunner. Al Getz is smiling now at ringside. Al Getz really is the ultimate front runner. You know that?
Absolutely.
He comes out here. Too Much has the title. A title his man Tyson Dean owned at one point here just a few months ago. Now he's out here with Tommy Too Much. Ultimate front runner. Wouldn't surprise me to see him try and go up to Gunner if Gunner ends up taking this title. Gunnar now with a reversal, too much into the corner. Big power slam from Gunnar. Is this the opportunity Gunnar can seize to get this matchup back in his favor? Gunnar trying to get up, the crowd solidly behind Gunnar. Very popular here with the NW Atlanta crowd. We have had Gunnar here before, so this is not his debut with us.
Absolutely.
Probably about a year to a year and a half ago, I believe. I don't remember the exact date, but he's been in here with us before.
I believe it was one of the Bash of the Bridges a couple years ago.
You may be right there. I have to go back and check the archives there on our YouTube channel and see where he's at. Big clothesline there. Back elbow for Gunnar sends Tommy too much down to the mat. Gunnar with a head of steam into the corner. Big knee lift right to the midsection of Tommy too much. Slingshot suplex there.
Oh, nice.
Great suplex there. Gunnar is feeling it now. This matchup may be close to being over for Tommy too much as Gunnar setting him up for the rack. Security trying to encourage Tommy too much here. Gunner's getting him up.
Oh, torture rack.
He's got too much up and out. Gets his up on the apron. Gunner's got him. Gunner's going to hit him. Tommy too much. Tommy too much hit him with the title bell right in front of Tristan
right,
Michaels.
Tristan saw it, yeah.
Calling for the bell now is referee Tristan Michaels.
The winner of the match as a result of the disqualification, Gunner!
Gunner wins the matchup here tonight, but Tommy too much is victorious or remains the heavyweight champion at NWA Georgia heavyweight champion.
As a result of the disqualification, Tommy too much remains NWA Georgia.
Oh, security now. Security in the ring getting handled by Gunner. Gunner is upset big time. He traveled hundreds of miles to come in here and face Tommy too much tonight. He's victorious. Gunner's victorious here tonight, but he leaves without the title belt as security takes the brunt of the beating here. TNA's Gunner victorious over Tommy Too Much tonight in the NWA Georgia Heavyweight Championship match, but Tommy Too Much retains the title.
Wrestling fans, the following contest is set for one fall. And now, introducing Oscar Worthy!
In case you have forgotten, my name is Oscar Worthy. Cue my music. Hailing from the Florida Everglades, weighing in at 270 pounds, he is the beast behind the mind. He is my hellhound. Please welcome the Destructor, Bill the Butcher!
Yeah.
and his opponent. From the Mushroom Kingdom, 227 pounds, and he is one half of the NWA Georgia Tag Team Champion, Drew Adler!
Big Chad, our second matchup of the night here pits the monster from the Florida Everglades. Bill the Butcher versus Drew Adler, one half of the NWA Georgia Tag Team Champions here with Fry Daddy. Referee Radar Martin calls for the bell. Smart move here by Drew Adler to take it right to Bill the Butcher here to start off this matchup.
Absolutely. William the Butcher,
as our friend Oscar Worthy has announced.
I wish I was from England.
You're going for a proper name.
I mean, I like America, but...
The food's horrible.
Yeah.
Really? We're two fat guys.
Yeah.
It's all about the food, honestly.
One last 5 minutes there.
Yeah, they don't have Pizza Hut over there, I don't think. Bangers and Mash or whatever that crap is they have. I'm not really sure.
That sounds like fun at a party, but not for food.
No. Well, maybe. I think you're thinking hash.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. But anyway, back to the action here as... Got Drew Adler with a front face lock on Bill the Butcher. Go behind there. Grab. Bill shakes him off. Drew Adler trying to get a hold of Bill the Butcher somehow. Not really sure where his head is or where his face is at this point. Adler going for some type of a cover as Radar Martin gets down. Bill the Butcher with a shoulder up. Adler, man, I tell you what.
He's got to grab the hair area over there.
Yes. Bill the Butcher can't even see. Trying to back Drew Adler into the corner. Can't even see where the corner is at this point. Bill the Butcher stumbling back into the corner. Adler there. Drop to hold right in the bottom turnbuckle. Goes Bill the Butcher's head.
Face first.
That's the first time I've seen him take a shot to the head. We're showing a little bit of an effect of it. Adler is measuring him up in the corner. Here, let's see Bill's back up to the vertical base. Going for the big boot is Adler. Adler misses there as Bill the Butcher almost falls out of the corner. Butcher setting him up. Oh, my God.
Wow.
Big suplex into the top turnbuckle there. Bill the Butcher is out also. Bill grabbing Drew Adler there right now. Oscar Worthy with a big grin on the side, on his face here as Adler now is out to the cold concrete here at ringside. Oscar Worthy with that ever-present umbrella. Have not seen him use it as of yet, I believe, in a matchup. But Worthy here, we've got to keep an eye on him, make sure he does not use that umbrella to his man's advantage here, Bill the Butcher. Bill the Butcher doesn't need it, but a tough competitor like Drew Adler, Oscar Worthy may be looking to seize any type of opportunity he has to make it easier on his man to win this matchup.
Yeah, I asked Oscar Worthy a while ago why he had his umbrella, and he said, tish, tish, it looks like rain.
All right, well, I'm not really sure what he thinks rain looks like, but okay. Ah, Bill the Butcher slamming Drew Adler right into the barricade here at ringside. What we use to keep the fans, double axe handle off the ring apron now onto Drew Adler. And outside the Florida Everglades, Bill the Butcher feels right at home outside the ring.
Absolutely. We've seen many a match that he just has taken to the people outside and have wrestled all over this building.
Yes. All over this building. He's been to the train tracks. Bill the Butcher with a head of steam going for the turn. Oh, my gosh. Drew Adler ducked out of the way, and Bill the Butcher went face first right into the ring post. Adler with a big kick there, a super kick right to the midsection of Bill the Butcher. Head right off the ring apron now. Radar Martin pretty much could just go sit down and have a sandwich now. As Adler and Bill the Butcher, Oscar Worthy trying to grab at Drew Adler's foot. Adler slid into the ring here, but Bill the Butcher took the opportunity to slam him right in the head as Adler slid into the ring. Fans getting on to Oscar Worthy here at ringside. Worthy right in the face of Drew Adler here now, taunting, talking to Drew Adler as Adler's getting punished by Bill the Butcher. You won't see any type of scientific moves from the great Bill the Butcher, a former NWA Atlanta Tag Team Champion as well, or NWA Georgia Tag Champion, taking on one half of the current Tag Champion. Oh. Bill the Butcher with that leg, that shin across the throat of Drew Adler. Adler now taking a choke of the foot from Bill the Butcher. Butcher taking a break right there in the corner now. Looks like he's measuring. What is he doing with his tape? Doing something with his hand here. Oscar Worthy once again taunting Drew Adler. Despicable actions here. Just absolute rudeness from the Englishman. Big left hand for Drew.
Not in England.
No, no, they're mad at us anyway. We won the war and all.
That's right.
Reversal there. Bill the Butcher head of steam. Using Drew Adler's own momentum off the ropes. So the back elbow right to Drew Adler's jaw. Hooking the far leg. Martin down for the count. Two count there. Oscar Worthy asking for a little bit faster count from Radar Martin. Bill once again punishing. There's no denying this man's talent. We've seen him pretty focused since Oscar Worthy's taken over his leadership role. Adler with a sunset flip as Bill the Butcher went in for a spear. Bill powered out of that. Big clothesline there. Butcher back elbow. Butcher stunned here but not off his feet. Drew Adler's going to have to work a little harder off the ropes now. Adler setting up for that face buster on the thigh. Head of steam from Adler. Bill the Butcher with a clothesline. Adler ducks it. Butcher down like a tree. I tell you what, incredible. Adler's going to have to regain a little oxygen here to be able to continue this attack. He's going to have to take an advantage here as he can. Oh, head of steam into the corner. Bill the Butcher gets those knees up. Quick scoop power slam there for Adler. Could this be all? Two count from Radar Martin there. Adler hooked the far leg, but it wasn't enough to keep Bill the Butcher down for three.
Oscar Worthy on the outside. Very worried about that last count.
He is Oscar worried right now. Adler setting him up. We're going to see that white noise move that Adler hits. Did not get that. That fireman's carry. Adler with a boot to the face here. Both of these men, their finishers, that foot to the face. Adler with a boot. Bill the Butcher with a bare foot. Adler setting him up. Wow, Adler hits that. Let's see if he's going to get it. Can he hook the leg? Oh, wow. I couldn't tell Oscar Worthy, but he did something with his umbrella there. I couldn't tell from our vantage point here, but Bill the Butcher at the very last second got that shoulder up. Adler is spent now. Let's see if he can muster enough to try and get this 1-2-3 count. Big spinning enziguri for Adler. And Bill the Butcher with a slow fall there. Adler hooking the near leg. Oscar Worthy's got Butcher's leg out from underneath the ropes. That's all it takes to break up that pinfall attempt. Oscar Worthy paying dividends here at ringside once again for Bill the Butcher. And Butcher's out here for a little bit of a breather. Oscar Worthy complaining of a hair pull. Whoa, Adler with a big drop. Wow. A Drew drop off the ropes. On to Bill the Butcher here at ringside. And the crowd is ecstatic. Oscar Worthy cannot believe what he's just seen.
I can't either, Vance.
He was inches away from getting drilled by Drew Adler, and Adler went right over the top of Oscar Worthy. Oh, Oscar grabbing the leg of Drew Adler as Adler slides into the ring. Oh, Bill with a big boot. Could this be all? Bill the Butcher down on Drew Adler. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Bill the Butcher.
Oscar Worthy proving dividends here once again with the distraction. Bill the Butcher hits the big foot, and Drew Adler is down for the 1-2-3. What a great matchup and a great win for Bill the Butcher. But Oscar Worthy here proves the difference, and I'm sure we'll see more of this here in the future. Drew Adler's going to want his revenge, I'm sure. Be joining Payne and Iceberg here in progress as the match just started here a few moments ago. Caller in elbow tie-ups, a couple of them to start off the matchup. Iceberg and Bill the Butcher. Oh. Wow, Iceberg and Payne here. Payne hitting the big splash off of the ropes. As Payne collided with Iceberg here, hitting chest to chest, and Iceberg down onto the canvas here as Payne is in control right now of the matchup. Big forearm right to the side of Iceberg's face. Another forearm right off the jaw there. We see Payne. Iceberg with a head of steam off the ropes, and both of these men meeting shoulders here, but neither one of them meeting the canvas. Oh, big knee lift right to the midsection of Iceberg. Iceberg losing the NWA Southern Tag Team Champions last night to Andy Anderson and Tyson Dean. Both men not with us here this evening as they've gone up to Tennessee as part of the NWA National Heavyweight Championship Tournament that's going on with the NWA SAW up in Tennessee this weekend. And both of those men are gone, but Iceberg lost the matchup. He and Gunner actually defended the titles last night at an event in Barnesville. Tristan Michaels is trying to save his own butt here. Payne is just like, just let me hit the man.
You know, I don't blame him at all.
No, not one bit at all. You're right there. Payne with a head of steam off the ropes.
Oh,
oh my gosh.
Wow.
Big backsplash onto Iceberg. I don't know that I know Iceberg has fought Vader in the past. I don't know that it's been a while since he's fought a man of this size. That's for sure.
Absolutely.
I'd say the same thing for Payne, obviously. Payne's got Iceberg there, letting Iceberg use his momentum there. Big forearm shot right to the top of Iceberg's head. Another shot right to Berg's head. Berg with an uppercut right to the throat of Payne. And a big, strong right hand from Iceberg. Another one into Payne's, the side of Payne's face. Payne does have that mask on. He heads into the corner now. Iceberg with a head of steam here. Whoa, big splash. Payne, this may be the first time he's off his feet. Iceberg with a head of steam there. Big clothesline as Payne hits the canvas. Iceberg going down. He can't hook that leg. Neither one of these men, I don't believe, will hook the leg tonight.
Oh, the mistress is very concerned about that.
Yeah. When you got an 80-pound leg to hook, that's not an easy thing to do, that's for sure. Iceberg looking at Tristan Michaels. These guys are going to have to pull out all the stops to beat the other man here, the size of both of these professional wrestlers.
Absolutely. Power versus power, brute versus brute, man.
Oh, absolutely. It's like two bricks colliding against each other. Trading shots here to the side of the head. Iceberg and Payne both absolutely worn out. Iceberg with a shortcut, thumb to the eye. Oh, my God!
Wow.
Payne got Iceberg up for a power slam. Payne has got to get the cover on Iceberg, but he doesn't have enough energy right now. That took everything out of him. As Payne is back up to his feet now. Iceberg now down here in the corner. Is Payne? No way. Payne setting up. Is he going for? Oh, my God.
He's going to the top.
He's going to the top rope, folks. If you have not seen this, Payne is going to hit that splash.
Oh.
Going for the splash. Iceberg, big veteran move there. It rolls out of the way. That's going to be all.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Iceberg!
Payne went for that splash off the top rope. Iceberg with a veteran move rolled out of the way. And Payne stunned as he hits the canvas. Iceberg rolls him up for the 1-2-3. And that is it, as Iceberg is victorious over the monster Payne here tonight. What is this? Bill the Butcher's in the ring now. Bill the Butcher and Payne. Oscar Worthy promised that they were going to have a showdown. Bill the Butcher with a couple of forearm shots to Payne. Not really sure what's happening. We're going to get some help out of the back.
Oscar Worthy controlling.
Oscar Worthy's not here. Payne dumping Bill the Butcher over the apron, over the top rope now. Butcher is hit hard on the apron and onto the floor now. Payne gathering Bill the Butcher up, hitting his head right off the barricade. These two men are fighting at ringside. The fans are going to have to watch out. Payne has Bill the Butcher by the throat, dumping him over the barricade. Payne's broken the barricade down.
No.
They're going towards a snack bar.
Oh, wow.
They're in the fans here. Payne bouncing Bill the Butcher's head right off of the snack bar facade. Payne head first out. Bill the Butcher headed out the front door. He threw something at Payne I couldn't see.
All those fans are scattering. Hopefully they get out of the way.
The fans are scattering and taking their phones out at the same time. That's smart. You never know what's going to be a YouTube sensation. Payne and Bill are still fighting outside the ring. Are they going outside to the parking lot? I can't tell. It's going to be out of our vantage point now. What on earth is happening? Payne and Bill the Butcher are now fighting outside the ring. All the fans are outside now. I'm not really sure what's going on. We're going to have to, Chad, get up and get outside. We'll see what's going on. Grab a wireless microphone or call into the studio. See what's going on. Payne and Bill are outside the ring now. The barricade's torn up. Half our fans are outside watching what's going on in the parking lot. This is absolutely incredible. I think they have tickets, Chad. I thought you were going outside.
Sorry.
Turned your mic off already. Sorry about that. Absolute mayhem here. Not really sure what's going on. Somehow one of the lights got turned on during the middle of this. Payne and Bill the Butcher may be fighting outside of the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall and is a fatal four-way Lucha Rules match. Two men will start. There will be two men on the apron. You can tag anyone at any time. If one man goes to the floor and is the legal man in the ring, anybody can replace him in the ring and then becomes the legal man. This can occur at any time. Ladies and gentlemen, it is one fall to the finish. And introducing first,
it's too late to run now. Let me upgrade to the next champ's hand, dog. You can get your ass beat. Your girl took your man squash. Keep climbing to the top of what I stand on.
The 219 pounds is the upgrade. Ryan Tay.
The moonsault king. Bada boom, bada bang. Trust me, it's that easy. I low boom, yo, trust me, I'm that greasy. And on the block, they ask me if I'm insane. They ain't ready for the upgrade. Brain came. You just got the ladder. I'm up 10 10. I'm the best thing down here in like 10 years. You see the blueprint for this, we design them. Until I D-I-E is M-A-I-M. And if you aiming for the top, you better come to me. I lay you down for the 1, 2, 3.
His opponents.
And beautiful.
He will be accompanied to the ring by his beautiful bald bestie, Hardcore Zach Edwards. He's from Star City, weighing 212 pounds. Marvelous Michael Stevens.
Obviously. Plain to see. You're everything I hope for. You're everything I need. We're bald and beautiful. Obviously. Can I be your new bestie? Beautiful, bald, and besties.
And the final participant.
Vance Keeney here along with Big Chad. We have a four-way Lucha Rules match. Unfortunately, Radar Martin speaks Spanish, so this is going to work out here. We're going to have two men start the matchup.
The rules is you have to eat a burrito before you get into the ring, right?
I believe so. I think that's it. At least one burrito. There.
A taco and a gordito are for $5 at Taco Bell.
Exactly. Exactly here. Yeah, Fry Daddy's going to start off with Damian Silva. Oh, the upgrade Brian Kane tagging Silva into the match, taking Silva out of the match. Whoever takes the pinfall in the ring wins the matchup. And Kane and Fry Daddy setting off to start the matchup here. It's Zach Edwards here at ringside with Michael Stevens and Damian Silva in the far corners here as Hammerlock on Fry Daddy, reversal from Kane into his own Hammerlock there. Fry Daddy trying to set up side headlock now. We've seen Brian Kane here in a couple of opportunities at NWA Atlanta. As you folks at home know the besties, Zach and Michael Stevens, and Damian Silva here at our last event had a good showing here at NWA Atlanta. So looking forward to this four-way matchup here this evening.
Absolutely.
Radar Martin, Fry Daddy breaking off Brian Kane with a big shoulder block there into Fry Daddy. Fry Daddy's on the canvas. Brian Kane with a head of steam off the ropes. Silva with a blind tag, it looked like. Here's Fry Daddy, hits a drop kick. Fry Daddy hits a drop kick on Kane as Kane comes off the ropes. Friday coming off the ropes there, and Kane back in Friday into the corner. Are we going to see a clean break here? I doubt it. Kane going for a big shot there. Friday with a big forearm right to the back of the head. Big elbow drop right in the top of the head of Kane. Friday with a big kick off the ropes now. Kane going into the corner. Looks like he's trying to tag Silva into the matchup now. He was full of vibrato about 2 minutes ago before Friday got a hold of him. Now tagging in the young rookie, Damian Silva. We've seen here in recent weeks, Michael Stevens trying to make weight to try and take on Friday for the NWA Georgia Junior Heavyweight Championship and has not been able to break that 210-pound mark.
Absolutely, and has gone on to actually beat him in the match. But
Zach Edwards is hobbling over here.
You see that, ladies and gentlemen? Marvelous Michael Stevens being a genius on the side. Why get in when you don't have to? We're smart bald people.
Smart bald.
Is Brian Kane an unofficial beautiful bald bestie this week?
That is.
I have a question.
I was wondering that myself.
Not sure. We know Fry Daddy's certainly not. They don't really care too much for him.
Not at all.
But, we'll see here. The taller of the three men in the match, Silva is, and Fry Daddy there, Silva with another go behind there. Picking up Fry Daddy, great amateur move there from Silva as he settles into a front face lock on the mat, trying to get Fry Daddy turned. Oh, Fry Daddy taking into a hammer lock now on the mat as Silva got some great amateur moves here for both men. And Silva reverses the hammer lock now on Friday. He's into a side standing headlock. Referee Radar Martin right on top of things. Lucha rules here, obviously. Got basically a four-way match here with two men in the ring at a time, making tags to opponents on the outside of the ring. Michael Stevens asking now that Friday's down, asking for a tag into the matchup now. Full of bravado here now. Big headlock takedown there from Silva. Silva's wrenching in that headlock now as Friday's down on the mat. Radar Martin checking Friday with a roll up there with a reversal. Two count from Radar Martin. Friday once again with that roll up.
Friday managing to get those shoulders over while he still has that headlock synced in, man.
Yep. That's a tough thing to do when you're losing your oxygen and that blood to the brain. It's tough to have your wits about you to even attempt that move, much less have the power to do it. Big arm drag from Friday sends Silva down. Settling into a wrist lock now. Friday Silva up to vertical base, clenching that fist. Oh, he's going to roll through, trying to get Friday to break the hole with a nip up there and a reversal of his own into a hammer lock there as Friday now is trying to think of a way to get out of this hold now. Friday with a reversal here. He's going to do off the ropes now. Silva trying to hold on. Friday with a roll-up. Is this hit? Only a two count there for Radar Martin. Friday going there. Now Silva with a roll-up of his own. Friday kicking out after one. Brian Kane there inching closer to Silva. Friday looking for a backslide here. Is this going to be all? Radar Martin's down. Just another two count there. Quick pinfall attempts from both men. Arm scissors there now. Now with another roll-up there from Silva. Wow, great pinfall attempts here from both men. Show of respect from these guys now as they are both exhausted from the multiple pinfall attempts. And now back up to vertical bases here.
I couldn't really see from this angle, but I think Zach Edwards may have had something to do with Friday breaking out of that pinfall.
It doesn't surprise me one bit. Silva trying to tag Michael Stevens. Oh. Stevens is the one in the matchup now.
They were just complaining about it just 5 minutes ago. My goodness.
Yeah, I tell you what, you know these guys are going to be here picking the bones. Something happens or somebody hits a finisher. Somebody gets an advantage here where it looks like they may win the matchup. Here come the besties. They're going to try and interfere, try and get a win, steal a win here tonight in this four-way match. Big chop to the chest. You can see the sweat coming off the chest of Damian Silva here this evening in the light here at NWA Atlanta here in Locust Grove. Another big chop to the chest. Michael Stevens, I don't think, wants any part of that. Neither does Brian Kane. Oh, Silva. Big vertical drop kick from Silva here since Friday down to the apron. Radar Martin now another two count as Brian Kane tries to come in to break it up but was able to stop here just in time. Kane with that shoulder heavily wrapped. I believe he has a springboard moonsault as his finisher. I believe that's what he what he does here. I've seen him at PCW at times. That's mainly his home base, I believe, is one upgrade Brian Kane. As you see, the beautiful ball besties to continue to strategize here at ringside. Michael Stevens there crouching to his partner, Zach Edwards at ringside, where they're discussing what to do and when to take an advantage in this matchup. Brian Kane obviously is thinking the same thing here. It's Friday, he headed into the turnbuckle. Brian Kane going to the opposite corner. Doesn't want any part of that. Got to stay out of the way. You don't want to get hurt, that's for sure. Head of steam from Silva with a big clothesline. This could be all. Asking for Radar Martin to come, hooking the near leg as Friday rolls up. Kane in, grabbing the leg, doing what he can to break up that pinfall attempt. He's trying to keep that keep this matchup in his favor. Michael Stevens complaining again to Radar Martin about not being able to make it into the matchup. Neither one of these guys, Friday or Silva, want to tag him into the match, but Brian Kane tags himself into the match as Friday backs into the corner. Kane going after Silva now. Friday stepping into the ring. Kane. Michael Stevens in with a double axe handle to the back of the head of Friday. Kane going for a pinfall attempt on Silva. Silva kicks out after only one. Friday stayed into the ring here as Kane made his way into the matchup on that blind tag with Friday in the corner. Silva worse for wear now. Boot right to the midsection of Kane. Kane hitting a clothesline on Silva, and Silva's barely being held up by the top ropes now. Kane setting Silva up for a big suplex right in the middle of the ring. Silva is down. Kane hooking the far leg. Kane taking a shortcut here. Choking Damian Silva here right in the middle of the ring.
As messed up as Michael Stevens' plan is actually not that bad of a plan.
Absolutely not. Let these three guys wear each other out. Then as soon as somebody gets close to your corner working a tag,
absolutely
come in and pick the bones, as I said, just like the vultures they are. You're going to take any advantage that they want.
Is it weird that I want chicken after you said that now?
Do what now?
You said pick the bones. Makes me want chicken.
Pick the bones. Okay.
I don't know. Sorry.
We'll get to eat after the show, Big Chad. Don't worry about that.
Okay.
Kane going in for a big move there in the corner. Silva, you can hear him crying out in pain. Oh, Michael Stevens pulling. Michael Stevens now in the match. Did you see a tag?
No.
Did Stevens tag Brian Kane as he was in the corner? I didn't see that. Not sure what's going on. Stevens came in and dragged Silva out of the ring. Silva's now back in the ring. Stevens going for a pinfall here, not hooking the leg. Very arrogant pinfall attempt there from Michael Stevens.
But I could be wrong, but if someone's out of the ring and somebody gets into the ring, they can take their place.
You may be right. I think you're right there.
For Lucha rules, anyway.
Okay, so that makes sense there, Big Chad.
You're supposed to tag somebody. You're
supposed to tag, but if they're
out of the ring,
okay, gotcha.
You take advantage that way.
Excellent. I understand what you mean there, Big Chad. That's why you're here.
That's why I'm here, yes.
Former NWA liaison to the NWA president, Bruce Tharp's office for NWA Atlanta.
Well, I do what I can.
There you go, absolutely.
Now I'm here with you, so.
Yep. Zach Edwards screaming at the fans here at ringside. Michael Stevens, reversal from Silva. Silva needs to find a way out of this matchup just to get some rest, get a respite here. Brian Kane looks like he's stepping into the match now. Silva's in some serious pain here. Kane going for a collar and elbow tie-up, backing Silva into the far corner. Big palm thrust right to the midsection. We haven't seen those since the days of Mike Cannon in NWA Atlanta. Kane has some loose tape there around his wrist. Kane choking Brian Silva in the corner now. Radar Martin can't see the tape as Kane unraveled it from his wrist. Kane stalking Silva in the corner now. Kane setting him up for a suplex. Oh, going! Wow. What a huge move there as Kane tried to pick him up for a body slam there. Got a 2 3/4 count out of referee Radar Martin. Michael Stevens once again, John Kane with a quick leg drop right across the chest of Silva. Radar Martin down. If Kane had hooked the leg, he might have gotten a three count there. Silva is gasping for breath. Kane tagging Michael Stevens into the matchup now. Brian Kane gets tagged back into the match here as Stevens exposes those ribs of Damian Silva and a shot right to the shoulders. Worse for wear from Michael Stevens as he exits the ring. And Kane back in control of Damian Silva. Big left hand right to the midsection of Silva. Another one from Kane. Haymaker there from Brian Kane. A left hand there. It tells you just how hard those abs are of Damian Silva. Kane shaking his hands. Silva getting a little bit of offense there now. Maybe those shots to the midsection woke him up there, but a big kick right to the arm and the chest of Kane. And Kane throwing Silva right out of the ring. Lucha rules. Here comes Friday. Friday with Kane's back turn. Big forearm right to the shoulders of Brian Kane. Friday now out of the ring is Kane here right near the barricade, right in front of the fans here. Friday with some shots. Big, huge right hands into Kane's head. Friday rolls Kane into the match now once again, and he's back in the ring. Friday and Kane now the legal men in the ring as Silva's trying to recover here at ringside on the concrete. Friday right wiping the sweat off his hands. Is he going to go to work on that shoulder? Brian Kane, I tell you what, he may have a shoulder injury, but how smart of it is to wear some big apparatus like that on an injured piece of your body here in a wrestling match?
I've never understood that. I really haven't.
No, I tell you, there's a reason the NHL has the rules that they do with their injury list so that you don't know what type of injury somebody has. They say lower body, upper body, whatever, that kind of thing. There's a reason for that, so those guys don't cone in on the injured portion of a competitor's body, but that's not the case here. Brian Kane says, I got your Superman. Big elbow drop.
Wow.
That left elbow right to the chest and heart of Friday. Let's see if this is all not hooking the leg once again, and that proves to be the downfall of this pinfall attempt as Friday kicks out after 2.5. Kane dispatching Friday to the ring. Damian Silva now finally recovering to get on the apron. And Kane pulls him right into the ring. Silva, did he recover enough to set a suplex up? Michael Stevens and Zach Edwards have left the ring apron. Oh, Kane with that body slam there. We've seen that before. Is this going to be all? Friday's in. Double axe handle breaks up the pinfall attempt now. Friday's in the ring. Michael Stevens has left the ring apron. He's gathered his stuff. Looks like he and Zach Edwards are heading to the back. Michael Stevens is headed to the back. He says it's unfair. Friday taking on Brian Kane and Silva here in the ring. Silva and Kane now teaming up on Friday, going for a backdrop. Friday said, oh, Silva with it. Chest first or head first. Oh, big Superman punch there as Silva's down. Friday hit the Superman punch on Kane.
Kane was holding him in like a DDT position.
Absolutely. And when Kane fell, he DDT'd Damian Silva.
Wow.
Friday's standing tall in the ring. He doesn't know who to go after. Friday eyeing up Brian Kane and Damian Silva both on the floor here. Friday hitting the ropes. He's going, oh, big suicide dive.
Oh.
Kane takes the brunt right across the chest. Friday with a suicide dive as Kane is on the concrete here now. Friday rolling Kane right into the ropes. Friday, oh. Is he going up to the top rope? High risk maneuver here for Friday. Kane trying to regain his bearings here. He's standing up in the center of the ring. Friday, is he going for that? Big missile drop kick here. Can Friday get it? Is this going to be the end of the match for Brian Kane? Damian Silva is still out after that DDT here. Big splash in the corner for Friday. Bulldog on Brian Kane. Friday is feeling it. The crowd is ecstatic right now as Friday. Signaling we're going to see that big elbow drop from Friday.
That's right, the Friday elbow.
Big elbow drop across the chest. Brian Kane is Friday here. Opening up the shirt. exposing the Superman. See if Fry down here is measuring Brian Kane. Kane doesn't know where he's at. You can see he's in La La Land right now, reaching out as he's trying to regain his composure.
Somebody, I guess.
Silva's up on the apron now just by referee Radar Martin. Silva, I don't know if he's going to have the ability to continue here. Brad Addy hits a cut line on Kane. This is going to be it if he can roll him over and get the pinfall. Silva's staggering back into the ring now. He's setting up Brad Addy. Going for a clothesline there. Brad Addy reverse it. He hits a cut line on him, on Silva. Silva's down now. Who is this? Zach Edwards is out now. Here comes Michael Stevens. They're back in. Pushing Brad Addy off. Michael Stevens is in. Hooking both legs, and this is it. What on earth? We knew this was going to happen here.
The winner of the match, Marvelous Michael Stevens.
Michael Stevens coming in at the last second and picking the bones. Friday hit the cut line on Brian Kane and the cut line on Damian Silva. Friday poised to win this four-way matchup. And in comes the Vultures. In come Michael Stevens to come in and get the pinfall here on Damian Silva. What an incredible matchup here. No less should we expect from these two guys, the beautiful ball besties, as Michael Stevens is victorious in this four-way match here tonight. All three competitors are stunned now as Friday, Brian Kane, and Damian Silva come out on the short end of the stick here tonight with the beautiful ball besties, Michael Stevens coming out and sealing the pinfall.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time is now! The main event of the evening, it is a loser leave town match. The loser of this match will have to leave NWA Atlanta indefinitely. And now, introducing first.
I'm too sexy for my love. Too sexy for my love, love's going to leave.
From New York, New York, weighing 199.5 pounds, and he is accompanied to the ring by the NWA Georgia heavyweight champion, Tommy Too Much.
Too sexy for my shirt, so sexy it hurts.
Get some straightening done. I am being accompanied to the ring by the No Pain Train Iceberg. And I hail from Muscle Shoals, Alabama. Tonight, folks, you might as well call me George Washington Carver, cause I'm gonna show you how to bust up a peanut. I am D-Wid Dawson!
DeWitt Dawson has found him the equalizer here at ringside, the No Pain Train. I tell you what, DeWitt is going to enjoy getting his hands on one Al Getz here tonight. The NWA Georgia Heavyweight Champion has returned shirtless to ringside here as his shirt was removed earlier this evening by TNA star Gunner, as Gunner took on Tommy here in our opening match this evening. Not really sure what to expect out of this match. Obviously, both of these men established, well-established managers in professional wrestling, but not entirely sure what on earth. Tristan Michaels here has found something on Al Getz.
A chain or something?
A chain. Tommy too much at ringside going after and grabbing DeWitt Dawson's leg. Tristan Michaels has found something else on Al Getz. Tristan Michaels found another chain.
Two chains. Apparently as he's found rap music.
Two chains. Well, obviously. Oh. You know, we've heard him rap before in the ring.
Oh, gosh.
I told you he was the fourth best Jewish rapper in the history of the world.
Oh, you did. You did.
Behind the Beastie Boys. He's found some handcuffs behind. Now. Al Getz has brought handcuffs to the ring. Tristan Michaels continues the inspection. Al Getz has had physicals given by doctors that are probably... What on earth is this, a wrench? What is that?
A wrench?
It might be Sunday before he's done checking on Al Getz. Tristan Michaels is checking him once again. Got his arms up, checking his armpits. Tristan Michaels calling for the bell now. Oh, DeWitt Dawson, look at that. He is smiling. He is happy. He has his Ricky the Dragon Steamboat tank top on tonight as Ricky the Dragon and Macho Man had their tremendous match at WrestleMania 3. Hold on.
Look.
Al Getz has asked for the microphone.
Let's just be honest. Neither of us are trained athletes. These people don't want to see us fight. You realize this is all a plan to split us apart, to keep us down. You know, you and me were a lot alike. And I want to paint a picture for you. Tyson Dean, Shane Marks, Andy Anderson, standing together, managed by Al Getz and his assistant, DeWitt Dawson.
Assistant? Son, there ain't a thing in this world I can assist you in doing but getting out of Locust Grove. I can outfight you. I can outmanage you. I can outwrestle you. I can outtalk you. I can outdance you. I can out anything.
Did you just say you can outdance me? You know what? I think it's time to put your money where your mouth is. Hey, DJ, why don't you play something with a little stank on it?
Al Getz and DeWitt Dawson taking on each other in a dance-off. A Rick Michaels patented dance-off nonetheless. Let's see what he's got. DeWitt Dawson with a shot to the head as Al Getz taunts him here in the corner. DeWitt says, I'm going to dance with my five fingers. And hits him right in the side of that bald head of his. And Al Getz is outside of the ring. Is he crying?
There's no crying in wrestling.
I think that there is sometimes, but Tristan Michaels, referee of this matchup, is counting out Al Getz. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. T t-shirt on DeWitt Dawson as the Dragon takes on the Macho Man fan. Al gets.
You know, the winner of the dance-off is Iceberg when he came out with DeWitt in the beginning.
That's true.
In my opinion.
Oh, my gosh. Oh. DeWitt sending Al gets into the corner here, and Tristan Michaels is down. Al with a big forearm right to the back of the head of DeWitt Dawson. Tommy Too Much is in the ring.
Uh-oh.
Iceberg is in the ring now. I think Al Getz forgot about Iceberg. Iceberg shoving Tommy Too Much out of the ring. Oh, big splash in the corner as Getz takes the splash. DeWitt Dawson is up. He's got him in a full Nelson.
Full Nelson. That's a legal wrestling move.
Tommy Too Much now. Outside the ring, the belt is in the ring now. Too Much. Iceberg has come over now, going after Tommy Too Much. Tristan Michaels is waking up enough. Al Getz is down. DeWitt with the far leg hook. This is it. Three count.
Gentlemen, the winner of the match, DeWitt Dawson!